It was a pleasant morning in California in 2018. A 68-year-old woman had escaped the harsh winter of Nebraska and had taken a yearly trip to a place called Carmel Valley. She was doing what she liked most, and that was trail running. Only this day, she rounded a corner and ran right into a swarm of flies. This was by no means out of the ordinary, but she later told doctors that this swarm was particularly annoying. The flies got in her mouth and eyes, she said, as she frantically tried to brush them away. A month later, and that woman complained that something was itching in her eyes. To her horror, she then discovered the source of the irritation was a squiggling worm, something which would later baffle doctors. What she had was called a zoonotic disease. That's when a bacteria, virus, or parasite from one animal is passed on to humans. Her particular disease was called Thalassia gulosa, and while it's actually quite common in the USA and Canada, it usually only affects cows. Doctors say now something weird is happening. That's the fact that these parasites are now getting into humans. We found another case, and this time the person was a 26-year-old woman, also from the USA. She said her eyes started itching, and so she investigated while she was working on a salmon fishing boat. She was horrified when she managed to pull out a worm that was about half an inch long. A spokesperson for the CCD's Division of Parasitic Diseases and Malaria had this to say about these strange cases. Cases of eyeworm parasitic infections are rare in the USA, and this case turned out to be a species of Thalassia that had never been reported in humans. This woman actually managed to remove 8 of the worms herself, which you can imagine wasn't the best job in the world. Doctors removed another 6 of the things, and in no time she was fine. The problem, though, is that if the worms are not removed, if that happens, there's a chance they might wriggle around so much that they cause damage in there, which could lead to blindness. If that doesn't make you feel lightheaded, the doctors in this case removed some worms that contained unhatched eggs in the larvae. And so what that means is these things can replicate in a person's eye. Leave those itches long enough and a person might find that they're home to a family of worms. A colony, if you'd like. This is what the CDC had to say about that. There were adult male and female worms in this woman's eye, and they'd obviously been able to mate. It's quite romantic in a way, isn't it? Anyway, they were having sex in her eye, and one of them is pregnant and has babies. It's said that the particular face fly that causes all the problems was first seen in the USA sometime after World War II. But while cattle or cats or dogs are usually the victim, it seems humans are now fair game. The word on the street is that because there's so much more cattle now, there are many more face flies of this sort. One of the women who had eye worms told CNN that when she first removed one of them, it was wriggling, but it died soon after. She also said this, "My left eye just got really irritated and red, and my eyelid was droopy. I was getting migraines too, and I was like, what's going on? I pulled down the bottom of my eye and noticed that my skin looked weird there. So I put my fingers in with this sort of plucking motion, and a worm came out." She said the first thing she did was run to her work colleague and scream to her that she just pulled a worm out of her eye. Then she went to see a doctor and an ophthalmologist, but they were stumped as to what was up because they'd never seen anything like it. After that, she got on a plane and went to visit other experts, but she said they were even skeptical about what she claimed. Worms don't live in human eyes, they first said, but they were wrong. She said she got lucky, though, because as she was talking to this doctor, she felt one of them wiggle. She said, "Okay, look right now, it's on the move." She was right, and the doctor saw the thing. "I'll never forget the expression on their faces as they saw it move across my eye," the woman said. Okay, so they found the worm, but it turned out that the rest of them were not so easy at all to remove, and at first the flushes didn't work. It didn't help matters that there was really not protocol for this, said the woman. This was new ground they were covering. She said it was not a pleasant feeling to know your eyes are host to worms, but the medical staff assured her that it was unlikely they'd burrow further in and would stay on the surface of the eyes. The woman later said, "I tried not to go to the darkest place. Like, are these worms going to paralyze my face or infect my brain or impact my vision?" You might be wondering why the flies are interested in human eyes in the first place. A doctor explained that flies really like tears because those tears are full of nourishment for them. The USA isn't alone. In Europe and Asia, there have been 163 cases of people being infected by eyeworms. But the eyeworm is not the same as the one found in the US. Their eyeworm is known as Calopeda. In Europe and Asia, the worms tend to pick on the young and the elderly, simply because those people are not as good at swatting the flies away. If you don't want eyeworms, then we suggest you don't let flies anywhere near your face, and get good at wafting them away. In the case of the runner we talked about at the start of the show, she was just unfortunate to run into a bunch of flies. It's actually a good thing that these people have talked to the media, because one of the women said at first she thought she was going mad. She searched on the internet for eyeworms, and no one had talked about it. So now you know, if you start feeling something wriggling in your eye, you probably are not crazy. The good news, according to the CDC, is that it's super rare in humans. You have way more chance of being struck by lightning or winning the lottery than having a bunch of worms crawl around in your eye. Now go check out diseases that will kill you the quickest. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.